Hello, in this video, we'll be covering model evaluation. Clearly, when considering evaluation models, we want to choose the one that'll give you the most accurate results. So here we'll introduce and discuss three types of evaluation models that can be used to help with this goal. These models are train and test on the same data set, train and test split, and regression evaluation metrics. We'll talk about what each of these are, as well as the pros and cons of using each of these models. The first evaluation model we'll talk about is the simplest one, train and test on the same data set. Essentially, the name of this model says it all. You train the model on the data set, then you test it using the same data set. In a general sense, when you test with a data set in which you know the classification for each data point, you're able to obtain a percentage of accurate predictions for the model. This evaluation model would most likely have a high training accuracy and a low out-of-sample accuracy, since the model knows all the testing data points from the training. We said that training and testing on the same data set produces a high training accuracy. But what exactly is training accuracy? Training accuracy is the percentage of correct predictions that the model makes when using the training dataset. However, a high training accuracy isn't necessarily a good thing. For instance, having a high training accuracy may result in an overfit of the data. This means that the model is overly trained to the dataset, which may capture noise and produce a non-generalized model. Out-of-sample accuracy is the percentage of correct predictions that the model makes on data that the model has not been trained on. Doing train and test on the same dataset will most likely have a low out-of-sample accuracy due to the likelihood of being overfit. It's important that our models have a high out-of-sample accuracy because the purpose of any model, of course, is to make correct predictions on unknown data. So, how can we improve out-of-sample accuracy? One way is to use another evaluation model called train-test-split. Train-test-split involves splitting the dataset into training and testing sets, respectively, after which you train with the training set and test with the testing set. This will provide a more accurate evaluation on out-of-sample accuracy because the testing dataset is part of the dataset that could have been used to train the data. This means that we know the outcome of each data point in the dataset, making it great to test with. And since this data has not been used to train the model has no knowledge of the outcome of these data points. So in essence, it's truly an out-of-sample testing. However, please ensure that you train your model with the testing set afterwards, as you don't want to lose potentially valuable data. The issue with train-test-split is that it's highly dependent on which datasets are trained and tested on it. The variation of this causes train-test-split to have a better out-of-sample prediction than training and testing on the same dataset, but it still has some problems due to this dependency. Another evaluation model, called K-fold cross-validation, resolves most of these issues. How do you fix a high variation that results from a dependency? Well, you average it. K-fold cross-validation, in its simplest form, performs multiple train-test splits using the same dataset, where each split is different. Then the result is averaged to produce a more consistent out-of-sample accuracy. This is better than using a single train-test split, where our model could test poorly due to a bad train-test split of the dataset, such as having too many outliers in the test set. This example here illustrates the basic concept of K-fold cross-validation. The entire dataset is represented by the points in the image at the top left. If we have K equals 4 folds, then one way we can split up this dataset is shown here. The results of each fold is then averaged, keeping in mind that each fold is distinct, where no training data in one fold is used in another. We wanted to show you an evaluation model that addressed some of the issues we've described in previous models. However, going in-depth with the K-fold cross-validation model is out of scope for this course. Thanks for watching.